Good morning. Welcome to Unity of Walnut Creek. My name is Sheila Gautreaux. I'm one of the ministers here at this amazing church, and it is such a delight to be able to welcome you this morning. We have an exciting guest speaker this morning, Dr. Brenda Wade of Television Acclaim as a relationship expert. She is going to be talking to you about creating sacred relationships. And our music this morning is by the wonderful Andoni Panici. So sit back and relax and prop up your feet and get ready for a wonderful experience. Have a blessed day.
Good morning and welcome to Unity of Walnut Creek. Please stand if you're able and join me in singing our opening song, Unite With Me.
Unite with me in peaceful prayer, unite with me in song. Together for eternity, unite with me. Unite with me in harmony, unite with me in song. Together for eternity, unite with me. Unite with me in brotherhood, unite with me in song. Together for eternity, unite with me. Unite with me in sisterhood, unite with me in song. Together for eternity, unite with me. Unite with me to bless this land, unite with me in song. Together for eternity, unite with me. Unite with me in peaceful prayer, unite with me in song. Together for eternity, unite with me. Together for eternity, unite with me. I feel the Spirit moving in 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 me. I feel the joy 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 moving in me. I feel the love 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 moving in me. I feel the presence 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 moving in me. I feel the Spirit 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 moving in me.
Good morning. Thank you to our song leader, Steve Pulliam. And I feel the Spirit moving up in here because we have, as our special guest artist today, Andoni Panici. backed up by our amazing house band Fusion. And we have a very special guest speaker today whom I'm going to introduce to you a little later in our service. I'll keep it as a surprise for now. Would you join me in welcoming our friends online? Just turn to the cameras and say, hey. Welcome to our service. It's a delight to have you with us each Sunday. If you're ever in the neighborhood, please come and say hello and experience us in person. Welcome to all of you to our service this morning. I'm Sheila Gautreaux, one of your ministers here at Unity of Walnut Creek. Welcome, welcome, welcome. And if you are new to Unity, a very special welcome to this positive path for spiritual living, for that is what we are here at Unity. We are also grounded in the power of affirmative prayer. Silent Unity has been praying for over 125 years for millions of people each year who call in, mail in, and ask for prayer for their lives. And we speak it affirmatively because we say yes to the action of God. The power within us that aligns with God, we say yes to that. Regardless of the circumstances of our lives, we say yes to God. So I invite you to join me in an experience of this affirmative prayer by saying together our opening statement. Together, there is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, the all-loving goodness of God. I invite you to take that in. Breathe it in through our hearts. Allow it to be so for you individually and for us collectively. And again, there is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, the all-loving goodness of God. And we take that in even more deeply and allow it to extend from our very being, moving through this sanctuary, extending out to our friends online, connecting us all together. And once more, there is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, the all-loving goodness of God. And as we allow that to resonate, we see it moving from the sanctuary out into our communities, out into our nation, over the mountains and across the seas, throughout the world, touching every heart that beats. And we know this to be true, to be the truth, for it could not be otherwise. And we are grateful. Please say with me, we are so grateful. Together, we are so grateful. And so it is. And together we say, amen. Please remain seated and join Steve in our next song.
Open my heart, Lord, I want to feel your love. Open my heart, Lord, I want to know you. Oh, open my eyes, Lord. I want to see your light. Open my heart, Lord. I want to know you. Open my ears, Lord. I want to hear your call. Open my heart, Lord. I want to know you. Open my mind, Lord. I want to know your will. Open my heart, Lord. I want to know you. Open my heart, Lord. I want to feel your love. Open my heart, Lord. I want to know. I want to know you. I want to know you.
As we begin this prayerful and meditative part of our service, I want to invite Heart Minister Ted Spady up to read our community prayer for today.
Prayer for the homeless. Today, our prayer is for who are homeless. From the place of compassion within our hearts, we send you love. We offer you a home in our hearts and pray that the shelter of God's love directs your way to a place where you find welcome, comfort, and peace. We allow the guidance and wisdom of spirit to awaken us to the realization of how we may be the eyes and ears, the hands and feet of God to support you along the way. We are one with you and pray with compassion that we might have the ears to hear the call to work together for a brighter tomorrow where all people everywhere have a place to call home. We thank you, God, in advance for the divine outworking of the building of the kingdom of heaven right here, right now, for all. And so it is.
Let us become comfortable in our chairs. As Reverend David likes to say, wiggle around until you find that comfortable space. And if you feel the urge, close your eyes to shut out any visual distractions. And breathe in and out through our hearts, allowing the chant of the sacred name of God and us to bring us more deeply into this experience.
I am.
as the presence and power within us that we call by many names: God, Allah, Jehovah, Yahweh. Breathe into the energy of the heart that opens the door to create the connection between us and the I Am. I am the love that cares for you, that comforts you, that supports you moment by moment. I am. I am the peace that stills the chaos of the mind and of the world. And allows rest for the weary mind and the weary soul. I am. I am the joy that thrills your very being, that facilitates the laughter from the deepest places within. Supporting you to find the good and the joy in everything. I am. I am the way, the truth, and the light. If any come unto me, I will give them comfort, provide them rest, and show them the way to the kingdom of heaven, right here, right now. As we rest in the place of our hearts for a few moments, let us bring all things unto that I Am to be transformed and healed at depth in the silence. Beloved I Am Presence, we feel your love. We surrender to your way. We allow your divine love to lift us to higher levels of awareness of the truth of our being. Within us individually and collectively, that we are one with you and each other. And we allow this divine love to move through our lives, filling each moment with the perfection that you are, transforming our everyday challenges into love and joy and peace and prosperity. We allow your divine love to flow throughout our world, blessing Mother Earth, blessing each and every aspect of her being. We allow this divine love to pour from us, enfolding and blessing the world. Divine love flows from my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. Please know this with me. Divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. And again, divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. And holding every nation and every person within every nation in our hearts once more. Divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world.
I am.
And so it is. Amen.
The song is called 100,000 Angels by Bliss.
Take
just a minute. Come and rest you by my side. Let me tell you your own story. Let me walk you through your lives. And only a second is all it takes to realize there's 100,000 angels by your side. There's 100,000 angels by your side. Do you hear me talk to you? I whisper through doorways and pathways of your mind. Clear as the morning. And fresh from my journey, cross an ocean of blue. Take just a minute, come and rest you by my side. Let me tell you your own story. Let me walk you through your lives. Only a second is all it takes to realize there's 100,000 angels by your side. There's 100,000 angels here this time.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Well, good morning.
Good morning.
My name is CL, and it is my pleasure, and I am honored to be up here as your platform assistant. Unity of Walnut Creek's prayer ministry is eager to welcome new heart ministers into the very important and vital part of our church's support system. Applications are available in the Book Center, and we need you to turn them in by February 7th, so if you're interested. Next Sunday afternoon, Reverend David will hold an information meeting about the four-day class offered in March called Write Your Book in a Weekend. It is crab feed time. Yay! And we do have crab. Tickets go on sale today in the patio, and this is a fun event where you can enjoy being with your Unity family and other people. There will be raffles, music, dancing, the usual. If you haven't come, you should try it this year because it's awesome. And now, Lisa, would you come on up and share with us?
Good morning. If you are able to attend activities here at Unity of Walnut Creek, you probably know Viola, our 96-year-old matriarch. You can't miss her. Petite, red hair, carries a cane. You may also know our friend Mario, who when he was 18 was in an accident and had a traumatic brain injury, and he was not supposed to be able to walk again, but you'll see him toddling around here using his walker. If you ever attend the 11:30 service once a month, you'll see our friend David jet up here in his wheelchair to be our platform announcer. So what do Viola, Mario, and David all have in common? They are all excluded from any activity or class that happens in the second floor of our education building. There are other people in our community who also cannot get up the stairs. Some people you wouldn't even know because they have invisible disabilities. For example, our stage manager, Annie, she has good days with her MS, and she has bad days with her MS. And so, in support of Viola and David and Mario and Annie and everyone else, I'm asking you to join me, in raising funds to purchase and install a lift to the second floor of our education building. The total cost of this is $25,000. The good news is, from some really generous donors over the last 5 years, we already have $8,000 raised. So the $17,000 that's remaining, it's my goal to have that $17,000 raised by the end of this year, which happens to be the year of compassion here at Unity. So there are many ways that we're going to be raising funds. Today we're going to kick it off out on the patio. We're going to have a table with handmade items from the ladies in our Threads of Grace group, and they're going to be on a love offering basis. There's also a Be the Change jar that would love to be the home of your loose change or bills or checks or whatever you want to put in there. You can donate online. There's a special page, Gift for the Lift, under the service drop-down. You can put checks, cards, credit cards, and cash in, those envelopes in the back of the chairs here in the sanctuary, and just make sure you mark it for the lift. And then we'll have other fundraisers going on throughout the year. Really, what I'd really like to do is raise the money so fast that we're actually able to install the lift by the end of the year. That would be I really ask you to help to join me in this, and I really appreciate your support. Thank you.
Thank you, Lisa. And yes, we have a lot of homemade items for you. You'll love them all. Now, find out more about these and other activities online and in today's bulletin. And now, until you hear the gong, take a few moments to greet those immediately around you.
The power of God is within me, I know, I know, I know. The power of God is within me, I know, I know, I know. The power of God is within me, I know, I know, I know. The power of God is within me, yes, I know, yes, I know. The love of God is within me, I know, I know, I know. The love of God is within me. I know, I know, I know. The love of God is within me. I know, I know, I know. The love of God is within me. Yes, I know. Yes, I know. The light of God is within me. I know, I know, I know. The light of God is within me. I know, I know, I know. The light of God is within me. I know, I know, I know. The light of God is within me. Yes, I know. Yes, I know. The peace of God is within me. The peace of God is within me. The peace of God is within me. I know, I know, I know. The peace of God is within me. Yes, I know. Yes, I know.
Okay. This next song is called Bridges of Love. It's written by Jai Josephs and Stephen Fisk. If we can build great bridges across the mighty waves between distant ridges, why are we still so far apart? Why can't we build a bridge from soul to soul and heart to heart? For now, more than ever, what this world needs more of is to reach for each other with bridges of love, love. If we can reach so far to send people to the moon, and rockets to the stars, is it a task so great to build a bridge across the depths of hate? For now, more than ever, what this world needs more of is to reach for each other with bridges of love. Bridges of steel reach from shore to shore, all but bridges of love, they reach so much more. They link our common hopes, our common ground, joining one and all, the whole world round. We all can build bridges of love each day, with our eyes, our smiles, our touch, and our will to find a way. There is no distance we cannot span. You see, the vision is in our hearts, yes, and the power is in our hands. For now, more than ever, what this world needs more of is to reach for each other with bridges of love.
more than ever. What this world needs more of is to reach for each other. With bridges of love.
Thank you very much. A hand for the band.
Doni. And speaking of building bridges of love, many of you may know this powerful woman already because of her many TV appearances on the Oprah Winfrey Show, Good Morning America, the Today Show, and most recently, the Dr. Oz Show. As an expert on relationships, her name is Dr. Brenda Wade. She is the author of 4 books and the founder of Sacred Relationships seminars that she has done all over the world. And these seminars have transformed the lives of thousands of people. She is also the host of a radio podcast. She is steeped in spiritual truths because Unity is her home. She has been attending and speaking at many Unity churches for a very long time. In fact, I just discovered where we met, and that was at the Church of Today in Michigan. It's now called Renaissance Unity, one of our very largest Unity churches. And she has spoken at Unity of San Francisco and many others. She has a background in science and psychology and spiritual principles that makes her a triple power when it comes to creating sacred relationships. She will be speaking to us today, but she will also be facilitating a powerful workshop at 2:00 this afternoon. I highly recommend it. And with great love, respect, admiration, I introduce to you Dr. Brenda.
With the music, with the meditation, I'm in that place my mother used to say, my heart is full. It's bubbling over, and all I can say is it's good to be home. I haven't had a chance to be in a Unity church in probably about a year. I've been on the road and tearing around, and I thought I better start by telling you how I found the Unity church. I went to school at the University of Washington, where I got my doctorate, and I was working in the monkey lab. I was studying prematurely born macaque monkeys to discover how they could learn to see and hear. Now, the lab was down in the basement of the medical school. It was dark, wet, and stinky. And it was a great place for me to be, because that's the state of mind I was in. Dark, very dark. I was very depressed. I was so depressed, I was dissociating. I would walk down the street, and I had this idea that I was invisible. Now that's pretty severe depression. Only I didn't know that's what was happening to me. I was just so used to feeling that way. I would just sort of walk there in my little 10 pounds of cloud and lead on my head. And it got so bad that one night I had a severe anxiety attack. I'd been up all night studying. I was taking pre-med classes because I was going to go to medical school and get a doctorate simultaneously while working my way through school. So I had this attack, and a friend came downstairs. We were in student housing, took me to the student medical center, and this really nice, tiny doctor, Rebecca Wells, I still remember her because she turned my life around. And the doctor examined me. She said, "Well, what do you think is going on with you?" I said, "Well, I'm having an anxiety attack. I figured it out. I know the symptoms. I've studied this." She said, "Well, why?" I said, "Well, you know, working my way through school, da 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 da." She said, "No." She said, "That's not why you're having the anxiety attack. You're having it because all those things are going on in your life, but yet you're sitting here looking as cool as a cucumber." Now, I thought that was a good thing, that I looked better than I felt. In fact, I was looking good while feeling bad. Now, I know none of you have ever done that. You know, the, "Yes, hi, I'm great, how are you?" Okay, that was my game. So Dr. Wells wrote something on a prescription pad and gave it to me. I thought, "Oh my God, she's putting me on medication for my depression." And I was desperate, I was gonna take it. It was the name of a therapist, Wilbur Bentz, I remember him too. So I ran upstairs to the student mental health center and started my career of therapists, coaches, anything I could find that could help me. And it was enough to get me through grad school. I got my doctorate, obviously, did a lot of research, did all the things I needed to do, got to my internship, which brought me back to San Francisco, and the depression hit again. Because unless you get to a place where there's a deep shift, it's impossible to transcend all that subconscious stuff. So a friend said to me, "You know what I think would help you, Brenda?" She said, "You should find the Unity Church." Now, of course, I ignored that. I wasn't going to church. I'd grown up in church. My brother, my uncles were all ministers. And it was the kind of ministry that was, you know what I'm talking about. You know, hellfire, brimstone, you're all gonna burn and rot and all the rest of it. So I didn't want any part of church. But I was out one day, and I tried to feel better by jogging, so I was out jogging along, and I looked up Unity Church, San Francisco, and I thought, "That's that church. You know what, I'm so miserable, I'm just gonna go," and I was sweaty, and bleh. I went right in. It was noon, they were having the noon meditation. People were sitting there meditating, and I just sat there. I thought, "Well, I don't know why I'm here, but I'm here." When the meditation was over, the woman leading the meditation, her name was Elizabeth, who was 88 years old, and she looked right at me. And she said, "Dear, when you came in, so much depression and resentment and anger came into the room." And I'm like, she called me right out and named all the things I was feeling. I thought, "I don't know what this Unity thing is or what they've got, but obviously I need it." And that was it for me. I started going to Unity. Elizabeth became one of my many spiritual teachers. I had many after that. And she taught me this powerful tool. Bless, 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 bless. Everything I was miserable about, everybody I resented, she said, "Dear, just bless them." So I started going around blessing, and I started feeling better. My depression lifted. And I'm happy to say that I found what, with all the therapy, which definitely helped, trust me, there's a place for therapy. I don't think I would have survived without it. But I needed the spiritual essence that I found in Unity. And that was the missing link for me, a positive, as you said when you started, Sheila, a positive spiritual path. So to be here today is an honor. It's a sacred trust for me. I know the value of a positive spiritual path from that dark, dark place. And one of the things I've learned in my work, and I get very emotional about this, is that with the psychology and all the science, because it's science up to here, and from neuroscience to quantum physics, and I studied physics for a long time because that lab was about the intersection of physics and how the brain works. What I do also know from my own journey is that we need to combine all those things to learn about love. So as I'm speaking to you today about sacred relationships, I am bringing all of those paths, science, psychology, spirituality, but most of all, I'm talking to you from my own struggles, as I think I've learned a lot from being a failure at love. Sheila just gave me a great word that I'd never heard before. She said, may I quote you? She said, when I met her at Church of Today, she said, my husband. What? I go, husband? I've never heard of a husband, Sheila. Well, guess what? I had two husbands. That's why I'm an expert in love. I've made every mistake. I've done everything wrong. And the only thing I can say to you, the good news is, I learned. I learned. Because it's really easy to say, there's the problem over there. No problem over here. Totally wrong. You all know that. This is unity. So I've got the advanced students in the room. So what I know about love is that we come to love with all of the wounds, all of the pain, all the places we were hurt or frightened when we were little, because when we're little, the brain is like this. It's a little fist. It doesn't have the ability to do abstract thinking, deductive reasoning. So when something happens to a child, the child looks at mom or dad and goes, oh! Not, gee, perhaps my mother is traumatized. Perhaps mother has intergenerational trauma that's never been resolved. The child says, what's wrong with me? And we take on a subconscious pattern of something must be wrong with me. And then, here's the worst part, we decide on something. So I made a decision. I was stupid, I did, and ugly. Both of these things were absolutely true in my mind because my poor mom, who was traumatized and she had 7 children, I would have jumped off the Golden Gate Bridge. After I became a mother, I only had 2. My husband and I had 2 children. Thank you, Sheila, you changed my life forever. And then I thought, how did my mother have 7? I have 2. And you know, they were little up at night when they were sick and being exhausted, and I understood. But the little kid in me had taken on a pattern. Now, this is how it works. I need a volunteer. May I have you, sir? Will you volunteer, please? Thank you so much. I get my volunteers. Anyone that looks like they're awake is a volunteer. Come right on up. Please, come on up. And what's your name, sir?
Merle.
Hi, Merle. So this is what happens. If I was traumatized as a child, and I feel I'm stupid, ugly, that means unlovable, and unworthy, no matter how wonderful and loving Merle may be, there's a part of me that wants to do what? Protect. I don't want to be hurt again. So I do a dance. Now, Merle, you and I have fallen in love, and you're a lovely man, and Merle wants to get close to me, and I want to be close to Merle, but it's going to go something like this. Hi, Merle. Don't get too close. Hi, Merle. Don't get too close. Hi, Merle. Well, you know it's your fault, Merle. If you would just change. Hi, Merle. Yes. Now, I know no one here has ever seen what I call the getaway closer dance. And getaway closer is predicated on a deep untruth. A, that little kid brain. Now, remember, prior to the age of 8, remember, little kid brain. Once, curl this. Merle, hold that right there. Okay. Once we get older, we get the cortex. First it's flat, and then it starts to bind right and left hemispheres, and you get a nice big bump higher cortex up here. And if you meditate and do spiritual things, it gets more developed. We get executive function. We can think about things, reflect. But prior to that, the child just runs on this. And this is the subconscious. It's what?
The subconscious.
And who runs our lives? Yeah, because the mind is an iceberg. The conscious mind is only the top third. Subconscious is the bottom two thirds. Now that sounds like bad news, and in some ways it is. But with the principles that we work with and some of the tools that I'm going to teach you very quickly, you can access the subconscious and change it. Would that be good?
Yes.
Okay. Now, Merle, I'm sorry for beating up on you like that. You're a lovely person. All right, thank you. Give Merle a hand, please. So the important thing is to become aware of what is in the subconscious. When we are aware, when we're what? Aware. Now, I want you to repeat it because this is where we get the accelerated learning, because I only have 20 minutes to teach you something, and normally I might have, you know, like a six-month class or something, so we're going to work hard and fast now. Is that okay?
Yeah.
All right. So the important thing is I am now aware of what's in my subconscious. Now, we're going to take a minute, and you're going to become aware. Is that all right?
Yeah.
I want you now, this is going to be hard. I want you to just put your hand here, because here the heart has memory. You know, after heart transplant surgeries, people started missing people they never knew, hating food they used to love, loving food they used to hate. And then that's when science woke up and went, Grandma was right. Your heart does know, because we have the same neural tissue here that we have here in the emotional side of the brain. This is a brain. 80% more information goes from the heart to the head than the head to the heart. Think about it. All right, so we're going to access that information. Is that all right? Tap, 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 tap with me. Thank you. We're waking it up. We're waking it up. Keep tapping. When you tap your heart, the heart goes, oh, talking to me? Yeah, we're talking to the heart. Now, I want you to ask yourself, when I was growing up, what was the most painful experience I had? Painful experience. For me, it was being 7 years old and having my teacher, Mrs. Fullendorf, accuse me of stealing money, and I hadn't stolen it. And I got punished for something I didn't do, and the injustice of it. Oh, it burned, it burned, it burned, it burned. So much shame. So what was yours? What was yours? Most painful thing. And you may be asking yourself, what does that have to do with love? The answer is everything. Everything. Did you get one? Did everybody get one thing that was painful? How many people got something? Can remember, ooh, you guys are good. You're good. Now that painful thing, I want to ask you, what emotion was attached to that experience? For me, the little second grader, it was shame and a sense of burning injustice. How could they do that to me? I was innocent. Okay, what was your feeling? Just call out some feelings. Sadness? Fear? Abandonment? Love? Good for you. It was my fault. Mm-hmm. Self-blame. Self-blame always leads to shame. Be aware, there's a connection. Shame is the lowest calibrating of all emotion. We have a scale, 0 to 1,000. You guys have heard about it, Dr. David Hawkins. From 0 to 1,000. When we get to 200, we start to gain power. Anything under 200, we are losing life force. We're losing energy. So our job this morning is to get way up above 200 and start gaining more power by saying, what's down here? What other emotions? I heard shame. I heard resentment. I heard abandonment. Why would someone who loves me hurt you? Now, nobody here has ever thought that but you. I want you to know that. You're the only person, right? Isn't she the only one who's ever thought, how could someone who loves me hurt me? Okay, we all have that experience. It's so universal, there must be a reason for it. There must be a purpose to it. So that, how could you do that to me if you love me? That encompasses so many feelings. That sounds familiar. My mother used to say that. This is for your own good. Yeah. Yes, exactly. And for a child, that doesn't make sense, does it? Right. And so what the child decides is love equals pain. Love equals pain. Now, how many people here have ever felt love equals, I'm just raising my hand behind my back, felt love equals pain? And if you think love equals pain, what will your relationships be like? Painful, because we now create what's in the mind. This is the secret of unity principles, isn't it? Change your mind, change your life. Connect to something greater than ourselves, that I am, I am, I am. Connecting to that. Thank you for saying that, dear. Pass her the tissues, sweetie. Please, Mark, give her the tissues. It's painful to access this stuff. But you know what? By letting it up and out, that is how we transform it. Now, is it okay if we transform this? Are you guys all right with this? You want to transform it? You sure? Come on up here. Come on. No, no, please. Yes, you. You've stepped out, and you're going to get the reward for stepping out like that. What's your name, sweetheart? Emily, are you kidding me? Okay, now how crazy is this, all right? My mother's mother's name is?
Emily.
I married a man whose mother's name was?
Emily.
My oldest sister's name is? I have a cousin named? All right. Hi, Emily. Obviously, you're part of the family. That is just sometimes, you know, zzzz. Yeah, like us wearing the same outfit when we showed up this morning. All right, Emily, thank you for sharing that. And I know it's painful. But the fact that the name alignment is here tells me that you and I are supposed to have this moment.
Yeah.
All right, so put your hand back on your heart. Everybody join her, hand on the heart. Take a breath. Now, the key to letting go is to give permission to feel what you're feeling, and it's okay, all right? It's okay to feel it. And take that breath and say, I feel the hurt that someone I loved and probably who loved me hurt me. I feel it. I feel the pain, the resentment, the anger, the shame, whatever it was. I let it come up. Now tap. I let it come up. I let it come up. I breathe right into it. I breathe right into it. And I'm going to give you some extra help right here. I'm going to tap the back of your heart too. We're going to let it up. Deep breath. Now, I let go and I let it flow. I let the feelings flow. The feelings that we try to tighten up on are the ones we never get to heal. We're going to let it flow. Is that all right? Okay. Now, what do you notice feeling as you're tapping, Emily?
Relief.
Relief.
Yeah.
Good. Good.
Letting go. Yeah.
Good. Look at her face. Can you see that she brightened up some? And she came up. She was more tight. Now, as you're letting it go, we're going to replace it with something else. What are we going to breathe in? Next breath. I am, everybody, I am 100% lovable. I am 100% lovable. Now, I'm going to ask you to do this. See that chain link fence of the fingers like this? We're now coordinating the right and left hemispheres of the brain. And when we get the brain, the two hemispheres working together, we double the dose. Now, I am 100% lovable. I am 100% lovable. Like you mean it last time. I am 100% lovable. Now tell the person next to you, you are 100% lovable. Now the person on the other side, you say, we are 100% lovable. We are 100% lovable. Can you feel it?
Yeah.
All right, so the brain will work with us. We want the heart, the mind working together. And in terms of the science, see the link? Show the link. Emily's art demo there. Very nice. Emily with the link. Thank you very much, Emily. This coordinating of right and left hemispheres, repetition, the brain loves patterns. It loves what? So when we can put something together and there's a pattern, the brain goes, I got it. I got it. That's why music is so important. We get that rhythm going. I've got it. I've got it. Okay, so could you give me a little beat? We're going to rock this, all right? I am 100% lovable. I am 100% lovable. Now we change it. You are, to your partner, 100% lovable. You are 100% lovable. Now we are 100% lovable. We are 100% lovable. Can you feel it? Yeah. Now, tonight when you go to bed, you're going to feel, we are 100% lovable. It'll go through your mind like that, and that would be good, yes? Yeah. Thank you so much, Emily. Give Emily a hand. Emily. You're the best. Thank you so much. Can't believe we have an Emily here. That's great. All right, last thing I want you to remember, because I know I'm keeping track, or am I? Who's my timekeeper? Am I on track? Where are you, darling? We're good? Thank you. All right, last thing, because I'm all about tools. And this afternoon, if you have the opportunity to stay for the workshop, we're going to drill down, because I want you to learn the five A's, which will protect relationships and protect you, and the five C's, which will destroy love. Very important that we know these, and they're all based on science. Now, anything I do is always based on science. I don't throw it up on the wall to see if it might stick, because I am a total geek. Or as my son-in-law says to me, I'm a blurred, a black nerd. Yes, a blurred. So I proudly own my blurredness and my geekness. All right, so one of the things that's important that I learned in Unity, in addition to the technique of blessing and affirmation, and I layer the affirmation, that little affirmation, I am 100%. Now, why do we say 100%? Because if you just do an affirmation and say, I am lovable, the subconscious is going, yeah, sure. You really think so? I don't think so. I think you're, you know, that scared kid who was hurt, and the subconscious is carrying on. Blah, 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 blah. We stop it by going, I'm 100%. The subconscious goes, oh, 100%. That includes me, doesn't it? So in order to take it to the next level, we only have one more layer that we need to add. What did we not include? Body, emotions, mind, spirit. What got left out? What did I hear? I heard somebody say it. The spirit is in the I am. This is our most powerful unity affirmation. I am, because what is I am? Moses goes to the burning bush and says, who are you? The bush says, I've traveled all over India and studied with gurus, and the things I've done to grow me and heal me, you have no idea. There isn't anything I haven't done. So I'm sitting on the sand, and in meditation, there's our key, meditation is where we listen. I was talking to Deepak Chopra not very long ago. I was hosting an event, and Deepak was our speaker. And so backstage, I said, hey, call him D. Hey, D. I said, how many hours do you meditate? Because he said, oh, I meditate hours a day. I said, how many hours? He said, 2.5 hours in the morning. And I went like that. He said, ha, 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 ha. He said, but I download a lot of material from the universe. Downloading material from the universe. So how many would like to download some material from the universe on making your relationship with yourself more sacred? Because why did I start with I am 100% lovable, then you, then we? Because it's through that universal connection that we are all one. We are what?
One.
I didn't feel that. I'm sorry. We are
one.
More important,
one.
Really feel it, because if there is any one thing that will transform our lives when we move out of that subconscious kind of backwash of I'm not good enough, I'm not, and we start stepping into I am 100% lovable. You are 100% lovable. We are all 100% lovable. What does that make us?
One.
Makes us one. We are one. This is the principle, the last song. Bridges of love. Your voice is beautiful, by the way. You guys rock so hard. We have such talent here. The key is to remember this principle. This is the core principle of unity. Say it. Unity. Unity. Uni. One. It means one. We are one. So to move out of my separate little miserable cocoon of blah, blah, to oneness. Okay, so if you don't mind, I invite you to stand up for just a moment. We're going to do our final tool together, and I need you to just look around the room as you say this. Take a breath. So let me just say, when I was in India, let me finish that little bit. I was sitting on the sand. I was at Sai Baba's ashram in Puttaparthi in southern India, and we'd get up at 4 a.m. and start meditating. There are about 100,000 people meditating together, women on one side, men on the other, and it's dark, you know, it's 4 a.m, and we meditate, and then the sun starts to come up, and then all of a sudden, as the sun hits, thousands of birds lift into the air. It's just magical. It's like the sun is some big gong that hits, and they take off. And then the music starts, a sacred music, and then the guru comes walking out and blesses everybody. It's quite something. But one of the mornings, I was there for 3 weeks, in the meditation, and I wrote about it in my Power Choices book, I saw all of us as points of light. It was the most profound spiritual experience I've ever had. I saw all of us in a net. And we were points of light. And those of us who are on the spiritual path, this was just an intuitive knowing. It was just like that. It wasn't thoughts. I just knew. We are pulling everyone else up. Our light is helping everyone around us. Does that make sense? That our light is multiplying light on the planet. And as we talk about bridges of love, do we need them right now on this planet? So we're going to step out in a very, very dramatic way this morning. Is that okay? Because we're going to send out our light and love where we know it's needed the most. Okay, so we're going to call out these unity principles. We're going to stand on them this morning. So I'm going to ask you to just go back to that. I am 100% lovable. I am 100%, stand for it, I am 100% lovable. You are 100% lovable. We are 100% lovable. Now here we go, stand on this one. ISIS is 100% lovable. ISIS is 100% lovable. ISIS is 100% lovable. Every place in the Middle East is 100% lovable. Homeless people right here are 100% lovable. Our government is 100% lovable. Whichever part of the government you believe in, they are 100% lovable. The part you don't like, they are 100% lovable. So I'm going to throw some love on Ted Cruz and Donald Trump. I love Donald. Okay, that was just me. Okay, now, here's how we live that. Take a breath. Dr. Herbert Benson at Harvard School of Mind-Body Medicine showed that chanting raises the vibration and it changes the brain. It gets more of that higher cortex going that I talked about. He said if we even chant the word one. 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 So as we are saying, I am 100% lovable, you are 100% lovable. We are all around this world. Now, I want you to see that net of light just for a moment. We're going to send it out. This world is 100% lovable. This world is 100% lovable. This world is 100% lovable. And now everyone in this world is 100% lovable. See it going out. Everyone in this world is 100% lovable. Everyone in this world is 100% lovable. Oh, thank you so much. It's such an honor to be with you. If you can, please stay for the workshop this afternoon. There's lots more. Thank you, Sheila. Thank you.
Well, that was powerful. Yeah. Are you all going to the workshop this afternoon?
Yeah.
I hope so. I'll be there. Now I'd like to ask you all to take a connection card from the seat pocket in front of you and then fill it out. Fill it out and add your prayer request for someone or something in your lives. Fill out the information if you're your first time here. Our heart ministers are available after the service for that wonderful personal prayer support. Even though you write it on the card, the heart ministers are there to pray with you. They're the ones in the lavender stoles. And prayer requests can also be sent anytime through our website. The ushers will receive your cards with the offering toward the end of the music. And now it is time for our prosperity celebration. For credit card donations, there are envelopes in the back of each chair. And for those of you at home, just click on the donate button on our Watch Live page. As Unity's co-founder, American mystic Charles Fillmore said, God is the source of a mighty stream of substance, and you are a tributary of that stream, a channel of expression. Blessing the substance increases its flow. Now I invite you to take your tithe or offering in your hand and be aware that God is the source. And let's repeat our affirmation together.
Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive.
All right. This next song is, I'll let you guess, it's called A Little More Love. It's by Jai Josephs and Harold Payne.
That all the problems that keep us apart can
never be strong enough to stop the power of a little more love. Just a little more love. We've been lying awake, searching for something to say. Wanting so much to reach out, but feeling so far away. We keep trying to figure it out, how to break through the distance and doubt. But it just might be that what we really need, and all we need is just a little more love, a little more trust in each other. If we're willing to try, we just might finally discover. Bridge. Love will be our harbor when we're lost at sea. And love is always the answer, whatever the question, whatever we need. And all we need is just a little more love, a little more trust in each other. If we're willing to try, we just might finally discover that all the problems that keep us apart can never be strong enough to stop the power of a little more love. Just a little more love. A little more love. A little more trust in each other. It's time for us to love. We got to love each other every day in every way. It's time for us to trust. It's time for us to love one another all along the way. Just a little more love.
Give yourselves a hand. Thank you so much. A hand for the band. All right.
Children, how are you? Yay! Great! I'm so happy to hear that. Well, we want to bless you because we just absolutely love and adore you. So everybody, would you join me in blessing and loving up our children? Ready? Children, you are loved, special, and important. The light of God shines through you. I think they're leaving. Let us join together and say our prayer for protection and our peace song. I'll do it the shortcut. Together, the light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is swell. And our peace song. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me.
Let there be peace on earth, a peace that was sent to me. With love and ever presence,
love, the light, and the peace in the earth right now. So let it shine and have fun.
Faster and faster, this world keeps spinning around. Seems like the more we build up, the more we tear each other down. All the progress and technology won't bring an end to war and poverty till we see that what we really need. A little more love, a little more trust in each other. Oh, if we're willing to try, we just might finally discover. But all the problems that keep us apart can never be strong enough to stop the power of a little more love, just a little more love. We've been lying awake, searching for something to say. Wanting so much to reach out, but feeling so far away. We keep trying to figure it out, how to break through the distance and doubt, but it just might be what we really need. And all we need is just a little more love, a little more trust in each other. Oh, if we're willing to try, we just might finally discover. Oh, love will be our harbor when we're lost at sea. And love is always the answer, whatever the question, whatever we need. And all we need is just a little more love, a little more trust in each other. Oh, if we're willing to try, we just might finally discover that all the problems that keep us apart can never be strong enough. Oh no. Stop the power of a little more love. Just a little more love. A little more love. We got to love each other every day, every way. It's time for us to trust, it's time for us to love one another all along the way. Just a little more love.